you're listening to Hexes and Soldiers Factoids, a series of tasty trivia tidbits called by poking a stick at curious historical episodes. In this episode, we'll look at Moustache, a black barbet dog, who was born in Falaise in Normandy, France, in approximately September 1799. At the age of 6 months, Canon states that he was sent to Caen to live with a grocer and whilst there encountered a group of grenadiers on parade. Goes on to say that Moustache followed behind the regiment, which had no other dogs, as it left the town and, on the approval of the drum major, was allowed to accompany the unit on campaign. The regiment was headed to Italy as part of the Italian campaign fought by France against Austria during the French Revolutionary Wars. Though Moustache was not a trained military dog, he apparently took to military life well, comfortably crossing the Great St. Bernard Pass through the Alps with the first consul, Napoleon Bonaparte's army, in spring of 1800. It is during this stage that one of Moustache's most famous actions is reputed to have taken place. Whilst the regiment was encamped near Belbeau, the Austrians are said to have mounted a surprise night attack on the camp in stormy weather conditions. It is claimed that Moustache noticed the approaching Austrian troops and barked to alert the grenadiers, who stood to and repulsed the attack. Other sources place this event as occurring in Alexandria, Egypt, during the Egyptian campaign against the Ottoman Empire. This variant may have been inspired by Napoleon's letter to General Auguste de Marmont just prior to the 1799 Battle of Aboukir, when Marmont was in Alexandria. It urged Marmont to provide an attack warning system by securing, quote, a large quantity of dogs which can be made use of by posting them in front of your fortifications, end quote. After this event, the colonel of the grenadier regiment is said to have formally placed Moustache on the roll as a grenadier and give him a collar bearing the regiment's name. Additionally, he ordered the Moustache receive the field rations entitled to a grenadier and that he be combed by the unit's barber once per week. Both Cano and de Favard say that whilst en route to Spinetta Marengo, Moustache took part in a small engagement between a company of his regiment and some Austrians. He was standing at the front of the company when he received a bayonet wound to his left shoulder. Moustache spent several days recovering in the hospital of the regimental surgeon. Though he's not fully recovered from the wound, still having a limp, Moustache is said to have taken to the field with the regiment on the 14th of June, 1800, at the Battle of Marengo. During the battle, he persistently barked at the Austrian forces and was only dissuaded from attacking them by their fixed bayonets. Moustache did engage in close combat with one opponent, a pointer, owned by an Austrian corporal that approached the French lines. De Favard says that Moustache quickly pounced on a larger, stronger dog and fought with him for some time before a musket shot killed the pointer. Cano states that Moustache was also wounded by the shot, losing an ear. Moustache deserted the grenadier shortly after the French victory at Marengo, apparently because one of them attempted to chain him to a sentry box, and instead joined a company of mounted cuirassiers. According to de Favard, Moustache was responsible for the discovery of an Austrian spy in the French camp just prior to the Battle of Austerlitz. The dog is alleged to have leaped to his feet and barked at the Austrian to alert French soldiers. Some sources state that this event occurred around the time of the earlier battles of Marengo or Aboukir. Moustache's greatest achievement is said to have taken place at Austerlitz. De Favard says that Moustache went into battle with cuirassiers and was present when the regimental standard bearer was surrounded by an Austrian soldier. The standard bearer apparently killed three Austrians before he was himself cut down, wrapping the flag around him as he fell to prevent its capture. It is at this point that de Favard alleges Moustache confronted the five or six remaining Austrians and was about to be bayoneted when the group was hit by a blast of artillery grapeshot. Moustache, wounded in the leg, is reputed to have torn the flag off the body of the standard bearer and returned to the French camp. In recognition of this action, Marshal Jeanlin is reported to have ordered that Moustache's old collar be replaced with a copper medal on a piece of red ribbon. De Favard states that this medal was engraved with the words, Et perdit une jambe à la bataille d'Austerlitz, et salva le drapeau de son régiment, on the front, and Moustache chien François, qu'il soit pour tout respect et chéri comme un brave, on the reverse, which translates to, he lost a leg at the Battle of Austerlitz and saved the regimental flag, and Moustache, a French dog, everywhere respected and cherished as a hero, respectively. At least one other source says, instead, that the medal was silver and had a tricolor collar. Moustache later had to have his wounded leg amputated. Other rewards he is said to have received for this event include an order being issued that whichever regiment he presented himself at would have to feed him the rations of a serving soldier, and that he was placed on the regimental books and was to receive the pay and rations of a soldier. Further legend states that Moustache was presented to Napoleon himself and demonstrated to have performed a trick whereby he would cock his leg whenever France's enemies were mentioned. At the Battle of Essling, Moustache was supposed to have found a mate. Upon joining the front lines, a fellow poodle was spotted amongst the enemy. During the course of the battle, the two met, and the female poodle accompanied Moustache back to the French camp. Their relationship lasted about a year, and together the pair produced puppies, which were looked after by the women of the camp. Moustache is said to have left the cuirassiers after he was struck by a cavalryman with the flat of his sword. Defivas says that he attached himself to a unit of dragoons, which he followed to Spain, taking part in two campaigns with them, during which he would walk ahead of their column and bark warnings whenever he heard a noise. During a battle in the Sierra Morena mountain range in the southern Spain, Moustache is alleged to have led back to camp the horses of dragoons killed on the battlefield. Shortly after this, he is said to have been secretly taken by a colonel who wished to own him. After spending 17 days in captivity, the dog apparently escaped by an open window and joined with a gunboat crew. Afterwards, he participated in the Battle of Badajoz, where he was struck by a cannonball and killed on the 11th of March, 1812, at the ripe old age of 12 years. Moustache was reputedly buried on the battlefield alongside his medal and ribbon, with a gravestone engraved with the words, "Ici repose le brave Moustache." Here lies the brave Moustache. Though he was wounded many times in his life, it is said that all of his wounds were to his front. After the Allied victory over the French in the Peninsular War, it is alleged that the Spanish destroyed his gravestone, and the Inquisition ordered his bones to be dug up and burned. This has been a Hexes and Soldiers Factoid. Tune in next time for another Hexes and Soldiers Factoid.